This woman, whose name we have concealed on request, says that on Wednesday last week she took her son, who had suffered a perforated intestine, to Mulago Hospital's casualty wing. She claims her son was only given an intravenous drip. For everything else, including blood tests and any drugs her son might need, she was directed to the clinics near the hospital.
Naye labu yankalubirira kubanga gye bwatuuka akawungeezi labu baali bamaze okuggalawo ne basindika wandegeya atuuka wandegeya ne bankalubiza nga okunkebera omusaayi baagala 10,000 obucupa bubiri baali balina okukeberamu obulwadde obulimu.
The situation prevailing at the hospital means that those without money to buy drugs or pay for the services outside are left to suffer helplessly.
Munange nawulira ennaku musajja baamutema yagamba baamutema baali bamuwadde ekitanda ngaali ku kipiira kyereere bwe kyali ne bwe baaleeta abalinawo ssente baamuggyako.
The spokesperson of Mulago Hospital, Enoch Kusasira, admits that the hospital had experienced stockouts of drugs and sundries in the recent months.
We had problems sometime last month, the month that ended yesterday, because of the end of the financial year. National Medical Stores was doing stock taking, and for about 2 weeks we did not have enough supplies, and that affected our operations.
On average, 10,000 patients visit Mulago every day, but only 13 billion shillings is allocated to them through the National Medical Stores to procure drugs. As the administrators here say, this money is not enough at all.
We are looking at 10,000 patients. How much do they use in terms of sundries? How much do we use when we are conducting surgeries? How much do you use on a patient with a head injury? If you want to create what they call titanium mesh to reconstruct the skull, you need about 7 million on each patient.
In the meantime, this woman and her son have to return to Mulago Hospital next week for further medication, but she's skeptical that the situation will have changed for the better. Herbert Ziwa, NTV.